We're going to talk about data validation. If you have a form that other people are entering information, you can use data validation to ensure that you get the right type of answers in your specified areas. So, for example, we have a dog boarding form. So, what I want here is I want to have the arrival date to be either equal to or greater than today. So, what I'm going to do here for starters is I'm going to go up to the A1 cell here, and I'm going to go equals today, and I'm going to go opening bracket, closing bracket, and that will give us today's date. So we're clicking in the cell where we want them to put the date in, and we're going to go on the data tab here, and we're going to select data validation. At this particular moment, you can put any value in there and that would be fine. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop this list arrow here and we're going to select date. And I want the date to be, they can arrive today or they can arrive anytime after today. So let's go and let's select the date and we want it greater than or equal to. And then we're going to click this little red arrow on the start date and we're going to click on today's date and press enter and we'll say okay. So if they wanted to enter 01012016 and press enter here, it's going to give you an error message. Retry. Okay. So that's how that works. You're definitely going to get a good date in here. So let's put in today's date. And that works fine. The next type part of the form that you're going to fill out is the dog's age. So let's click in the cell where they're going to fill out the age. And let's go to data validation. Now we want the value there to be a whole number here. We don't really want to know that they're 4¼ years old. We want to know that they're 4. So we're going to select a whole number to make sure that they haven't entered anything incorrect. Let's put less than or equal. And let's say, I don't imagine there's many dogs that are 25, but let's say 25 just to make sure they haven't entered in something in an error. And so we'll say okay. And so once again, let's type 35 in here. Press tab, and you receive the error message. So that's working perfect. So let's go cancel, and now let's enter 5. Now, the next field is the type of dog. This is a field where people might get carried away writing little stories about what type of dog, how happy or how good he is and everything else. So let's restrict the type or the amount of text that can be supplied in here. So let's go drop this down and let's go a text length. Let's go less than, and I don't think that there's a breed with more than 20 characters in the name of it. So let's say less than 20 characters long is what the response has to be. Okay, so let's go, let's type a whole bunch of K's here and press enter and you get your error message one more time. So let's just type in lab. And it works. And so now we have the third use of data validation. So how active is your dog? Let's give them 3 choices here. So let's go back to data validation and let's select list. So let's say that they can be very active. Somewhat active, So each option is separated by a comma, and you can put as many as you like in there. And so we say OK on this one. So then when you notice you have a drop-down list here. So you can select, let's say, somewhat active. So that is a good use of data validation. Please subscribe.